we should give instructions to the parents, very important about what's meant by epilepsy, what is the prognosis, what is the importance of the regular intake of medications, what is how is dangerous to stop the medication suddenly. This is very important. Usually minimal restriction is our target, okay, in the daily life activities, but it is wise for a case with generalized tonic-clonic convulsions to avoid contact sports maybe, or unsupervised swimming, domestic buses, horse riding, and cycling. These unsupervised activities can be dangerous for a patient who may have attack of generalized tonic-clonic seizure. The anti-epileptic medications, we have rules for its use. We not use medication for a single brief attack or even to infrequent minor seizure activities. We use it for the established diagnosis of epilepsy with two seizures with 24 hours apart. Monotherapy is ideal, okay, based on type, okay. For example, for generalized epilepsy, we will start with valproate, while for focal epilepsy, we'll start for carbamazepine and so on. So monotherapy is ideal. We start with one medication and then increase the dose till reaching the maximum dose. Okay, so for either the seizure become controlled by the dose, or when adverse effects become unacceptable, so we should resort to another one. Alternative monotherapy can be used before using the combination therapy, to use more than one, where we will try to withdraw the first one after reaching the full dose of the second one, trying to achieve the ideal option of monotherapy before resorting to the combination therapy. We usually stop the anti-epileptic medication after 2 to 3 years of seizure-free period. Anti-epileptic medications categorized into first line, second line, and the new anti-epileptic drugs. The first line includes sodium valproate, carbamazepine, phenytoin, and phenobarbital, while second line include the isoxtamide for absence and the clozapine. The new anti-epileptic medications include lamotrigine, topiramate, levetiracetam, and vigabatrin. Carbamazepine is the first line option in focal epilepsy, okay, and considered a second line after sodium valproate for generalized epilepsy. Serious adverse effects in the form of ataxia, Stevens-Johnson syndrome, and cytopenia can occur in the form of leukopenia and thrombocytopenia. Sodium valproate is the first line in generalized epilepsy. However, it can be used in all epilepsy types, but has adverse effects in the form of hair loss, weight gain, okay, for which valproate is not preferred by adolescent girls, and resorted to another medication as lamotrigine during the adolescence period, usually done. Other adverse effects include liver dysfunction, so liver functions should be followed and monitored during valproate therapy. Cytopenia also, full blood count should be done intermittently to detect these adverse effects. So follow with a full blood count and the liver function testing. Also, for avoidance of these undesirable effects in the adolescence period, especially in females, some other new anti-epileptic medications can be used as lamotrigine. Lamotrigine is suitable for all seizure types. It is one of the new anti-epileptic medications, can used as an add-on therapy to valproate in a combination therapy, but is not licensed to be used as a monotherapy under 12 years. And so we say we started to see lamotrigine used in epileptic children during the adolescence period, but can cause severe skin rash. Vigabatrin, also one of the new anti-epileptic medications. This first line medication in the West syndrome, we will discuss it now. Characteristically and very frequently asked questions, the side effect of vigabatrin is visual field defects. Trying to classify epilepsy, okay? Epilepsy can be classified as generalized, okay, or focal. Another classification would be idiopathic, where no cause can be identified for the epilepsy, or symptomatic when there is a cause. For example, cerebral malformation, okay, or inborn error of metabolism, maybe. So finding a cause. Other causes may include post-infectious causes or the causes we have just mentioned, okay, genetic mutations and so on. In these, we call it symptomatic epilepsy. Otherwise, it is idiopathic, which is the more common. Okay, there are other types of epilepsy that cannot be classified under these two, cannot be classified into generalized or focal, cannot be classified into idiopathic or symptomatic. This includes these terms, some of which need to have a knowledge about it, like West syndrome, Dravet syndrome, Lennox-Gastaut syndrome, and neonatal seizures. Also, neonatal seizures cannot be classified under these classifications. So what is generalized epilepsy? When both cerebral hemispheres discharge abnormally from the onset of the seizure. Okay, we have abnormal neuronal activity in both cerebral hemisphere. This will give us a generalized epilepsy. We have also types under the generalized idiopathic generalized epilepsy. This includes the tonic-clonic, generalized tonic-clonic seizures, where we have involuntary muscle contractions that can be sustained or tonic, or interrupted or clonic movements. Sometimes it starts as tonic and then complete as clonic movements, or maybe alternating tonic and clonic movements. So this is the more common idiopathic generalized epilepsy, which is the generalized tonic-clonic convulsions, which was previously termed the grand mal epilepsy. Other type includes the absence. Childhood absence epilepsy is a form of idiopathic generalized epilepsy when we have in usually a female 6 to 7 years old having episodes of staring in the space, losing her activity, lasting for about 10 to 30 seconds. Okay, she is unresponsive during the activity, but no loss of posture. Okay, and after the episode, she resumes her previous activity. This is the absence. Okay, myoclonic epilepsy also is a form of generalized epilepsy where two cerebral hemispheres discharge from the onset of the event, where we have brief muscular contractions. It's not tonic, not sustained, or not clonic, not interrupted, but it is a brief muscle contraction that can be single, occur once, or can be repetitive for a few minutes, okay, with preserved consciousness characteristically. Okay, myoclonic epilepsy is a form of generalized epilepsy. Atonic epilepsy also, it is a generalized one where we have sudden brief reduction in muscle tone resulting in loss of posture. This can be seen also in case of head drop, when sudden loss of tone of the neck muscles will result in head drop. This is a form of atonic epilepsy, which is a generalized epilepsy. Focal epilepsy, when we have abnormal activity initially confined to one part of the brain, not post-cerebral hemisphere discharge, but one part that start discharging, and may remain as a focal discharge, or may be then secondarily generalized and become focal with secondary generalization. This focal epilepsy can be simple, okay, simple focal seizures or epilepsy. By simple, we mean we have no impairment of consciousness. And this can be motor, okay, motor phenomena limited to one part of the body. Can be sensory, not motor, okay, autonomic, as skin color changes, maybe. Can be psychic in the form of sense of fear, visual or auditory or olfactory hallucinations, okay. So as we have mentioned, seizure not necessarily a motor one. It can be these forms. By complex partial seizures, we mean that we have impairment of consciousness, which not necessarily mean complete loss of consciousness and falling to the ground, but just the impairment of consciousness when the child is not responsive. Okay, this can be commonly in the form of automatism, where a child has a semi-purposeful behavior. He is doing something, okay, that is stereotypical, have the same pattern, but it is semi-purposeful, okay, and the patient looks vague and unresponsive. Okay, so this is complex partial seizure. EEG characteristically have focal changes limited to certain regions in the brain, mostly arise from the temporal loops, okay, where carbamazepine is the drug of choice in focal epilepsy. So what's meant by epilepsy syndrome? Okay, epilepsy syndrome, it is a condition where we have a collection of characters confined or limited to this syndrome based on age of onset of the abnormal events and the type of the event or seizure. It's a character, the characters of episodes and so on, and also characteristic EEG finding usually present. So certain syndrome have certain age of onset, certain type of seizure, and a certain EEG finding. This defines the epilepsy syndrome. We have many syndromes, some of which are important to know or to have some knowledge about it. For example, the juvenile myoclonic epilepsy, childhood absence epilepsy, and when older, it's called the juvenile absence epilepsy. Other syndrome can have just names about it, like generalized epilepsy with febrile seizures, and so on. While we have focal epilepsy syndromes, focal epilepsy syndrome where we have focal discharge, some which also are very important to know a knowledge about it. Idiopathic focal epilepsy include benign childhood epilepsy with centrotemporal spikes. This is very important. Orolandic epilepsy, also the autosomal dominant frontal lobe epilepsy. Symptomatic focal epilepsy include temporal lobe epilepsy, frontal lobe, parietal lobe, and occipital lobe epilepsy when we have certain events associated with changes, okay, in EEG arising from certain lobe in the brain. Now we will start to discuss some of these syndromes that have certain characters, starting with the infantile spasm or West syndrome. Infantile spasms, okay, or West syndrome, this usually affect infants 5 to 9 months age, when the child stop progression of his developmental milestone and even regression occur with loss of his acquired milestones. This is a severe form of epileptic encephalopathy with poor prognosis, where we have a characteristic pattern of epileptic seizure in the form of SALAM attacks that are characterized by involuntary muscular movements causing flexion of neck and trunk muscles, followed by extension of upper and lower limbs. These characteristic attacks called the infantile spasms that characteristically occur while the infant is awakening from sleep in the morning, associated with developmental regression and associated with a characteristic EEG pattern called hypsarrhythmia, where we have this shouted appearance of EEG during EEG recording. It can be idiopathic, okay, or can be symptomatic, finding a cause like inborn error of metabolism or HIE, or usually it is linked to the syndrome of tuberous sclerosis, where this neurocutaneous syndrome characterized, diagnosed during infancy with these characteristic attacks. Vigabatrin, usually the first line medication for treatment of West syndrome, followed by steroids or ECTH treatment also can be used. It generally has a poor prognosis. Lennox-Gastaut syndrome is another epilepsy syndrome that also has a poor prognosis, a severe form of epilepsy with onset between 1 and 7 years, commonly follow the West syndrome. Okay, so can West syndrome evolve into Lennox-Gastaut syndrome, where we have multiple seizure types, tonic, atonic, myoclonic, and atypical absences. Episodes also of status, convulsive and non-convulsive status epilepticus, common for this syndrome. It has a characteristic interictal EEG finding also that diagnose the Lennox-Gastaut syndrome. Pyridoxine dependent seizure, other form of epilepsy syndrome, which has autosomal recessive inheritance, characterized by intractable seizure, especially during a neonatal period. So any newborn or infant up to 3 years of age who has intractable seizure, not responding to the ordinary or conventional anti-epileptic medication, should have a trial of pyridoxine or V6, okay, injection, as it can respond very well to it and diagnose the pyridoxine dependent seizure. Dravet syndrome is a severe myoclonic epilepsy of infancy that has early onset epileptic encephalopathy associated with mutations in the genes for voltage-gated sodium channels, so resulting in intractable myoclonic focal and generalized seizures, complicating prolonged febrile seizures. Okay, another epilepsy syndrome, which is very important, okay, and has a benign course, that is one of the generalized idiopathic epilepsy, is called the childhood absence epilepsy. We have just mentioned usually a girl who is 6 to 7 years old who has episodes of staring, okay, which may be very frequent, okay. She is doing something and suddenly she stops her activity, staring in the space for about 10 to 30 seconds, and then she resumes her activity, but she is unresponsiveness during the episodes. This is very important. Episodes can be very frequent, up to 20 times, up to 100 times a day, and in this case, this will impair her academic performance. The characteristic for this type of epilepsy is the EEG finding, where we have generalized discharge in the form of symmetrical 3 Hz spike and wave discharge. This is a frequently asked question. When we have this characteristic EEG, we have here normal EEG pattern, and after episode we have normal EEG pattern, and during the episode that can be provoked by hyperventilation, asking the child to hyperventilate for 1 to 3 minutes, okay, this can provoke the epileptic seizure, showing this characteristic EEG pattern of paroxysmal 3 Hz spike and wave. This is a spike and wave pattern, is a characteristic EEG pattern that is seen in the absence epilepsy. This pattern emerges abruptly, okay, out of normal background, and suddenly ceases after few seconds. Usually have a benign course. Sodium valproate is the first line treatment. If not responsive to sodium valproate, isoxamide can be used, followed by lamotrigine during the adolescence period. Juvenile absence epilepsy is the same presentation, but with a later onset at 9 to 12 years old, and often have tonic-clonic seizures as well as the absence. Another important epilepsy syndrome, but it's focal epilepsy, one of idiopathic focal epilepsies, is the benign Rolandic epilepsy or benign childhood epilepsy with centrotemporal spikes. From its name, we have characteristic EEG pattern with spikes discharge from the temporal loop. Okay, this is the most common idiopathic partial epilepsy of a childhood, which is predominantly nocturnal, usually occur after awakening the child from sleep, where he has a sensory aura, okay, that is followed by motor seizures, motor abnormal activity involving his tongue, his lips. Pharynx can give some sounds, and also a shrugging of his arm can occur. Sometimes associated with aphasia, this abnormal activity involving tongue, lips, and pharynx can prevent him from speech and have a transient aphasia during the episode. 75% of seizures occur during sleep. The prognosis of this syndrome is excellent. Okay. As regard to remission, characteristic EEG finding can be present. Another syndrome called the Landau-Kleffner syndrome, or epilepsy, this epilepsy again has a characteristic finding in EEG, where we have continuous spike and wave in slow wave sleep. Okay, this is characteristic, continuous spike and wave discharge during sleep. This is very important. Here we have a child who is 2 to 10 years age, who has insidious onset of severe receptive and expressive language disorder, leading to aphasia, which is sometimes accompanied by generalized tonic-clonic disorder. So the child has receptive and expressive language disorder. He can see, okay, what occurring in front of him, but he cannot understand. He cannot understand the speech, can understand photos, so he cannot interpret the data given to him. This is receptive language disorder, and also he cannot express what he is thinking of and what he wants to say. So he have expressive language disorder, leading to aphasia. Okay, we should think of Landau-Kleffner syndrome, that is acquired epileptic aphasia. Doing an EEG will show characteristic finding in the form of epilepsy, of continuous spike and wave discharge during sleep. Another syndrome of idiopathic generalized epilepsy is the juvenile myoclonic epilepsy. This is the most common idiopathic generalized epilepsy syndrome of adolescents. Characteristically, a male or female adolescent awaken in the morning, okay, awakening from sleep while brushing teeth or combing hair, develop myoclonic seizure in the form of brief muscular contractions, often occur in the upper limbs, as can be associated with generalized tonic-clonic convulsion or absence. It usually have a good response to sodium valproate, but take care, myoclonic epilepsy can be exacerbated by carbamazepine therapy. This is also a frequently asked question.